Is the crypto market done and is Shiba Inu going straight to the ground, or will Shiba Inu and the crypto markets as a whole recover? We're going to go over everything in today's video and make sure you turn on that notification bell to get all of these updates instantly. And there's a link down below to help you grab two free stocks valued up to $1,800. First of all, the crypto markets are down as a whole right now. We got Bitcoin down 10%, Ethereum down 15%, Binance Coin down 19%. And when we go down to Shiba Inu, it is down 15%. Most of the time when it comes to the meme coins and the highly, highly speculative cryptocurrencies, they will go down the most, but Shiba Inu seems to be hanging in there with everybody else, being down around 10 to 15%, with the exception of a few. Maker is down 24%. A couple of these are down over 20%, but Shiba Inu is, it's holding up slightly well, but you know, doesn't really matter how much it's down. Everything is down. First of all, when things are down and you're sitting there, what should I do? Should I sell off or should I buy more? That's when you really have to ask yourself, do I believe in what I'm holding? Do I believe in it? Whether it's a stock, whether it's a crypto, sit there, ask yourself, do I believe in the crypto markets as a whole? When you're holding Shiba Inu, you have to believe in the crypto markets as a whole, because Shiba Inu is based off a very strong community. And if the crypto market is doing terrible, then Shiba Inu is going to do terrible. If the crypto market is doing very good, Shiba Inu will do very good and maybe even better than some other cryptos because of how strong the community is and other reasons, okay? So you really got to sit there at this point when everything is red and ask yourself, do I believe in the crypto markets as a whole? Personally, me, yes, I do believe in the crypto markets as a whole long term. Whether it's going to go down another 10, 20, 30, 40%, whether Bitcoin is going to go down to 20K, it's going to recover long term, in my opinion. And that's what you have to ask yourself when it comes to crypto, when it comes to stocks, whatever stock you are holding. Do I believe in what I'm holding? And this is a great time to ask yourself that, because when it comes to a stock or a crypto and somebody asks me, why is this stock dropping? Why is this crypto dropping? First of all, I ask them, do you believe in it? Let's say they say no. For example, I don't really believe in it. I don't really know what the company is all about. I don't really know what the crypto is all about. I don't know really much about it. Then I'm like, you should sell. You should honestly not be holding something you don't know anything about. You should not be holding something you don't believe in for long-term growth and long-term potential. Keep in mind, back in 2017, when Bitcoin ran all the way to $20,000, you know, it had a bit of a dip down to 13K during that period of time. On December 15th, 2017, it was 17,000 or more. It hit 20,000, but right there, I saw 17. And December 22nd, 2017, it dropped all the way down to 13K, and it had a dead cat bounce all the way back to nearly 20K before, you know, having a serious bear market for nearly 3 years until it started recovering in June of 2019, all the way back to around 12, 13K. I think it hit around, it might've hit 13, 14K around that point. And then before COVID came around, and then it dropped all the way back down to, I think it hit a low about $3,000 all the way back then. That's when the smart people were buying in. And then we had this massive run. Nobody knows what's going to happen next, but what a lot of big institutions are doing right now, they're buying in on the dips, okay? That's what a lot of the major institutions are doing right now, while the uneducated retail investors are selling for a loss. And you don't want to fall under that category. You don't want to be selling for a loss, but you have to know if you believe in what you're holding. If you don't believe in the crypto markets as a whole, you should probably sell. If you do, maybe buy the dips. Not financial advice at all. But just think about it. Do you actually believe in what you're holding? Whether it's a stock or a crypto, you must ask yourself that and you must know what you are holding. Shiba Inu is currently number two on the most viewed cryptocurrencies on CoinMarketCap.com right now. And Bitcoin is number one basically because of the crypto market crash. Everybody wants to see what's going on with Bitcoin, what's it going down to. And that's, you know, that makes sense. Obviously makes sense. If the crypto market's crashing, everybody's going to be looking at Bitcoin first, because Bitcoin basically determines what else is going to go down behind it. And seeing Shiba Inu at number two is a very good sign that it still has the community behind it, a lot of eyes on it. So taking a look at the chart, I set this up all the way back when it had that massive run up after the Vitalik burning news. And I set this chart up and it was following very well on these support lines and these resistance lines. As you can see here, 1648, a good bit ago, that was serving as a very great resistance point. It broke that, and then it tried to break the 1722 level, and it could barely break that. Went down into the channeling, and then the crypto market crash happened, and now we're all the way down to these levels at 811. As you can see here, this support level, it was playing very well. You know, the crypto market crash, it broke below this 950 support level. It was trying to break above it, but the crypto markets were way too weak. Everything was way too weak. It could not break above that level, and I'm not surprised. And now that we broke below this 952 level, we have to see it break back above that 952 level and regain that support and make that support now resistance. Right now it is resistance, and we need to break that level and make that support. And then the next level after that you have to look out for is the 1334 level. If you see Shiba Inu get back to that 1344 level, you know things have gone very, very well and things are starting to recover. But for now, we got to break that 95 level. And that's a very, very important level to break to, you know, see some further gains. We have some brand new exchanges listing Shiba Inu. As you can see here, HitBTC has officially added SHIB to their platform. When it comes to volume, HitBTC is number 23 out of all cryptocurrency exchanges. When it comes to volume, they're not up there with KuCoin or Bitfinex, but they are above exchanges like Bitstamp and CoinTiger and some of these other exchanges that you guys may have heard of. So HitBTC is a very, very good listing. Shiba Inu has also been added to CryptoMat. This is another exchange. It's not nearly as big as HitBTC or, you know, KuCoin or Binance or anything like that, but any listing for Shiba Inu is a very, very good sign, and any new exchange listing will bring in more volume and bring in brand new holders. We're going to go over some of these Discord messages from Shaitashi, one of the developers of Shiba Inu. Make sure you subscribe to get all of these updates instantly. You guys probably have not seen this yet. You may not have, but he was responding to a question. Shaitashi, what are your plans and motivation for the community to keep the price intact? We're tanking. He said, I think Shiba Swap will solve this. So good sign, him talking about Shiba Swap, kind of hinting the fact that it's going to come out soon. And he thinks that Shiba Swap will help the price tremendously. I agree. I think the price will bounce if they do release Shiba Swap. I don't know how long the gains will last. If the crypto market starts to recover, the gains may last, you know, a lot longer, and it may cause the price to go up even higher. But if the crypto market is still tanking and is still red, it might not hold the gains, but we'll see what happens when it comes to that, okay? Another message Shaitashi was responding to, can you confirm Shiba Swap is real? And he said, of course it's real. This isn't a game. You have to understand the magnitude of what we are about to do. What I did want to go over when it comes to this message is the fact that they are having a new Wolf Paper 2.0 coming out. If you guys don't know what the Wolf Paper is, it's basically just a whole rundown of what Shiba Inu is all about, what they do, what their plans are, and just basically a whole overview of the coin. Shaitashi was talking about Certik. He said, the audits have not begun and the size of our swap warranted deeper security measures. If you guys don't know what this is, for example, SafeMoon, they are onboarded. They got confirmed by Certik, and it basically gives you, you know, just a bunch of rankings of how secure the coin is. So SafeMoon, they have a security score of 85. And, you know, that's pretty good for most of the coins I've seen on here. The community voted that it's 97% secure, and they have a score of 85. So Certik did approve SafeMoon. And then if you go to Shiba Inu, it says they are onboarding and they don't have a score just yet. So we're basically waiting for Certik to confirm that Shiba Inu is safe, legit, and this will give a pretty big boost in confidence for investors. Shaitashi in Discord responding to this, as if they would announce a swap site for a release during a market correction phase. He said, I lost with you, I didn't tether, and he bought the dip. So Shaitashi's trying to give some investor confidence, letting you know that he didn't sell. He bought the dip and he did not put his money back into cash. And just today, Shaitashi said the explanation comes tomorrow and a new Wolf Paper shortly will come after. Shaitashi in the Discord or whatever platform he may use, Twitter, Discord, he plans, you know, a big explanation of what's coming, Shiba Swap, a bunch of new news I expect to be coming out of that. And tomorrow, they also plan to release a new Wolf Paper, which is basically the same thing as a white paper. Quick update from Kai Green. Kai Green is a social media influencer. He's a bodybuilder. He has 300,000 followers on Twitter, and I think he has millions on Instagram. He said Shiba Swap should be dropping soon for all of you Shiba holders. So, and honestly, when I saw Kai Green talking about Shiba Inu, I was wondering genuinely if he got paid to promote. And this was a comment right here, and I looked into it. I was like, does he get paid to promote? I didn't think he would, because I don't think Shiba Inu actually pays anybody to promote their coin. I think if somebody wants to promote it, They just go ahead and promote it if they do want to. And he actually addressed this. Somebody said, I'm sure he's getting paid from Shiba to promote it so much. He said, to be clear, I'm not. And I believe that because I did figure out that they do not pay anybody to promote the coin, which is good. You really don't want to see the developers paying people to promote the coin because that's just really not a good look for the coin and the community as a whole. So that is pretty much it for today's video, guys. If you do not believe in Shiba Inu, you probably shouldn't be holding it. If you do, maybe buy the dip. It's up to you guys. I don't know where the market's going to go. I have no idea. Nobody truly knows. But if you do want to join the $10,000 penny stock challenge, there's a link to the Patreon down below. You get extra stock picks, private Discord, and you can also get 2 free stocks valued up to $1,850. This is pretty much free money. I got a $100 stock in this other day, so it's really awesome. If you haven't made a Webull account, just go ahead and sign up. Check it out. That's it for today's video, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace.